Turn off or silence your cell phones or electronic devices and rise for a moment of silence and a pledge to the flag. Roll call.
Bonacic?
Here.
Turnbull?
Here.
Amo?
Here.
Anagnostakis?
Present.
Benton?
Here.
Berkman? Benelli?
Here.
Cheney?
Here.
Dillard? DeSalvo?
Present.
Ekis?
Here.
Fagione?
Here.
Hines?
Here.
Chemnitz?
Here.
Kulisek?
Here.
O'Donnell?
Here.
Paduk?
Here.
Riskevich?
Here.
Sullivan?
Here.
Bureau?
Here.
Brescia?
Here.
19 present, 1 absent.
Okay, before we go to our proclamations, I'd like to welcome all the students for youth and government today. I was very impressed with the mock sessions. I'd like to thank Legislator Tom Fagione. Excellent session. At the beginning, when he called for a motion, you could hear a pin drop, and then everybody started percolating once the questions started getting asked, and it was really, really spirited, and I was impressed. You know, you had Mr. Dennis Houlihan there over on this side who wanted to legalize everything, and the lady with the braids, I don't know your name, she was over here. Ty?
Yeah,
she got every opinion out in three breaths, I think. You know, she was really spirited, but it was fun, and you called on Legislator DeSalvo, who I think is one of our youngest legislators, so he almost could have been up here. The youngest, I stand corrected, the youngest legislator. Interim Chairman Fagione asked for an opinion, and you didn't know you were going to get a filibuster out there when you asked for it. But no, it was great, and thank you for coming. I hope you learned something today. With that said, I would invite up the county exec and Nadia Allen for the first award, Janet Eckerson from the Mental Health Association as well, Mayim Green, I hope I pronounced that right, and Stacey Orzel. This is for Autism Awareness Month. And then Sexual Assault Awareness Month, I'd like to invite up Legislator Michael Amo and Nadia and her whole team. And then Animal Cruelty Prevention Month. I'll call them when we get up there.
Good morning, members of the legislature. Good to see everybody. I want to introduce my two, we have actually a county executive, which is Logan. He's from the Cornwall School District. He's been with us this morning. And we have Ryan from the Washingtonville School District, who is shadowing Wayne Booth, but I told him to come with me because the deputy county executive doesn't work as hard as a county exec. So, isn't Wayne here? Okay. We saw him. We were just breaking shops. But, Mr. Chairman.
Do you want to do the introductions, or it's your proclamation? I signed it. So, Nadia, you want to do a little synopsis? Yeah, come on up. You're a better speaker than I, that's for sure.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Chair. Good morning, County Executive. Good morning to all of you. Here we are again. We were just here a year ago, right? So I really want to thank you again for the opportunity to do these two proclamations. It means the world to us and to those that we serve. The proclamation is going to speak about the statistics, is going to speak about the prevalence of autism, and I think it's important to understand that autism is a spectrum, okay? So there's a lot of stereotypes what a person with autism looks like, but the reality is at the end of the day, they're individuals just like you and I, and all individuals with autism want is the opportunity to have the services that they deserve, the funding that they deserve, to have concerted, connected, coordinated treatment and supports, and most importantly, an opportunity to be a full citizen with full participation in our society. So we are very lucky to be here, and we have some speakers, and who is first, Stacey? Yeah, and Stacy, who comes every year with us, she's a mom of someone with autism, and then a sibling of a young man with autism, is going to say a few words. Stacy Orzel, please.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, everyone. Thank you, County Executive Newhouse and your team. Good morning, everyone in the legislature. Thank you for your time, your attention, your commitment. Thank you to all the students who participated in the mock trial. I heard it was a good one. Congratulations. I would like to thank everyone in the audience for making some minutes to be here today. Parents Run Amok, in partnership with the Mental Health Association in Orange County, is a non-for-profit organization. We're dedicated to raising public awareness for autism spectrum disorders. We aim to raise better understanding, awareness, acceptance, and of autism through the education within Orange County. In addition, the majority of the money that we raise through our fundraising efforts goes directly to help families, to help them pay for necessary therapy, education, parent trainings, or equipment that a child may need. Our stipends that we disperse are also used to help children participate socially in the community through sports, art programs, and other opportunities that families feel appropriate. We hope to continue to increase our community partnerships, creating successful paths through education and employment opportunities for our local families affected by autism. Thank you, Patty Bassey, for joining us today, representing the SUNY Orange program. They have a wonderful program, Jay, I'll speak about a little bit more about, called Bridges. As of 2016, our volunteer parent-run organization celebrates helping families affected by autism in Orange County for 13 years. We've offered over $320,000 to local families. Proudly, Amok now sponsors four Special Olympic teams.
The Thunderbolts.
A new hat I wear proudly is Coach Stacy in the swimming pool. We're training over 100 athletes participating in competitions throughout the Hudson Valley. Coach Jamie and I, thank you for being here, Coach Jamie. Also, we have with us Coach Kelly, basketball, bowling, and swimming. Thank you, ladies. They're doing a great job. We're giving athletes and their families a wonderful opportunity to participate, and our teams are all unified, welcoming our siblings and our families to be able to contribute. Proudly as an Imam, a coach, and an Amok volunteer, my older son, Jason, participates on our swimming and basketball teams, and he's here today to share some of his current accomplishments and talk about some of his concerns for local families affected by autism. Thank you, Jay, for taking your time.
You guys should seriously have some Jeopardy music on the sidelines for when waiting happens. Just a few speakers, like the one up there. Little button. Hi. Hi, everyone. Hi. Oh, never had that happen before. All right, anyway. My name is Jason Wiesel. I'm in seventh grade. I play the cello, and I umpire Goshen Little League baseball and softball. And along with being coach for the swim and basketball. No, stop. Jeez. Well, because I thought it would make more sense if we did my paragraph and then we did all of his stuff. You know, I'm more important than he is. Thank you. Jeez. Coach on the Thunderbolts, both swimming and basketball. As my mom said, we are training over 100 athletes and participating on the four teams, track and field, bowling, basketball, and swimming. Our team's motto is teamwork makes the dream work, as stated by Coach Jamie many times during every tournament, especially when we're losing by like 10 points, but you know, forget about that. I love being up close and personal and involving myself with the fun. Proudly, Parents Run Amok sponsors our teams. County Executive Newhouse, this one, I'm sure you already knew that though, works very hard in Orange County making positive differences for families and businesses. I did some research on the county website and found some comparisons indicating financial and employment improvements. Regarding our county budget, in 2013, Orange County used $36 million of the fund balance
But in 2015, Orange County used $0 of that fund balance, and this balance is now a surplus. In 2015, unemployment was at 6.4%. Now in 2016, which I guess was last year, but employment rate was dropped to 4.5%. And in 2015, what?
I mean,
Amore's Pizza's already got me for when I'm 16, but maybe when I'm old enough for politics. In 2015, 6,600 jobs were lost, yet in 2016 twice. The first one was 2015, this one's 2016. 7,400 jobs were gained. Last year, my speech focus was, in the words of the great Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Rest assured, Dr. King is proud of your continued efforts doing for others. Great job, County Executive Newhouse and your team. All right, well, enough about him. He can talk about himself his own time. I'm sure he is. Many of you know my family is affected with autism. This year I have, especially taught my brother Eric, who is now 10 years old, this one. Funny enough, he wore that shirt. He's three here. He wore that shirt until he was, actually last year, somehow. I don't know how. How to be a deep end swimmer. Now that participates in Special Olympics competitions. Recently, Eric placed second in freestyle and fourth place in backstroke. In basketball, I like to play hard along with side of the other athletes. This Sunday, I look forward to competing in Special Olympics Unified Game at SUNY New Paltz. On the court, Eric is passive, sadly. I work hard teaching him to steal the ball. Steal the ball. Don't just stand there. My fellow coaches and I are often shouting, get the ball! Get it! To everyone! It's really funny sometimes. Anyway, I encourage Eric to get his sweet spot and hopefully be in position to take a pass. In recent competitions, Eric stole the ball, scored a basket, and always has a great time. Of course, this is the most important part. Every person should have opportunities to have a great time. That is the transition to my focus for this year, creating opportunities for persons of all abilities to have a path for a successful and meaningful life. I think it is important for businesses and organizations, as well as educational institutions, to think outside the box and create meaningful employment opportunities, especially for young adults with the autism spectrum. An autism fun fact that I picked up from my dad, recording back there, along with the other, that's a much more fancy camera over there. He said, some people think inside the box, some other people think of outside the box. People with autism tend to think about the box. Okay, parents run amok is excited to inform the Orange County Legislature about this innovative new program offered by SUNY Orange for individuals with developmental disabilities called Bridges Program. According to Ms. Bassey, who's over there, the director, parents and advocates for those with autism spectrum disorders and other developmental disabilities are advocating for new life opportunities once their loved ones leave transitional school setting at age 21. SUNY Orange, we already have a paparazzi. SUNY Orange has responded to this need by creating the Bridges Program, a post-secondary education experience, with the motto, college is an option. I think it is important to continue education after high school, and I'm glad the Bridges program is an option. I also believe it is important to set personal goals, for example, short term. It can be anything from going to go outside or going to go hang out with friends. Everyone does these kinds, sets these goals. Long term could be I'm going to go get a job. And everyone, once their parents and their guardians are gone, they need to provide for themselves. This could be a not so fun fact, unless we push independence and create opportunities to help pave the path for success. I did some additional research to learn what companies may be offering employment to folks affected by autism. Here are some examples. Autumy Works, based in Chicago, provides back office and operation work for people with autism. Rising Tide Car Wash, which I learned that you were following them on Facebook. That's funny. Based in Florida, 35 out of 42 employees have autism. It is structured, easy work, and is a good job that is needed. This company was funded by the dad of a young man that works at the place. Microsoft has a new pilot program as of 2010, which really isn't all that new, that hires adults with autism in multiple locations of coding, software programming, and math jobs. Sam the Dancing Barista, I don't know if any of you have seen this on the Ellen Show, he is a young man with autism and wished to be a coffee barista. Sam was hired by a local Starbucks and is one of the best employees they've ever had. And that's a fun fact, is that 35% of young adults with autism are unemployed, and 40% of Americans that are homeless have a developmental, physical, or mental disability. Personally, I think our nation should do better with helping people that need it. In closing, I share one of my mom's favorite quotes by Margaret Mead. Never doubt the small group of thoughtful communities, citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has. Thank you. This person will come up here who I don't know who is.
It's always an honor. I think the legislature and I, we always look forward to Jason coming here. Sorry, we do appreciate you, Stacy, but seventh grade, Jason, very impressive. I think one of the major takeaways, not only to bring attention to autism, but you have Chairman Brushes sits on the IDA, and there's a key message here that Jason talked about. We need to get every company that comes to Orange County where it's located here, they're getting benefits or they're not getting benefits or they're getting assistance from one way or another from either the IDA or the partnership or even local government to come here. We need to encourage them to hire people with what Jimmy Burpo says in the back, our purchasing director, not disabilities, but capabilities. And we do have a lot of employers here that we're very proud of, but I think that we can always do more. And I think the numbers that Jason talked about are really eye-opening. So, Mr. Chairman, I know you share my views on it.
Absolutely, I certainly do. And Jason, thank you for that speech. Very heartwarming, and don't feel bad, because I say stop to my mother, too, quite a bit, you know? And Legislator Anagnostakis and Legislator DeSalvo and a few others, too.
I swear, she's always up late trying to sort through all her photos, and I'm like, just take less. And she's like, no, I have to take as many as I can to get the perfect one.
I can empathize.
Already has the perfect one.
I know exactly how you feel. But thank you for coming today. This proclamation is very long. I'll read the first whereas in a second. My youngest son is on the spectrum, so I can empathize in some small degree with what you're going through, and really appreciate you bringing the awareness. And did you grow about a foot in the last year? You were a little shorter. Wow. Next year, you're going to be this tall. Great speech, though. And Nadia, thank you for your team coming today also. The Autism Awareness Month in Orange County, whereas autism is reported to be the fastest growing and third most common development disability in the United States, affecting thousands of people in New York State, and now therefore be it resolved that I, Stephen M. Newhouse, Orange County Executive, and L. Stephen Brusche, Chairman, do hereby proclaim April 17th as Autism Awareness Month. And do we present this to you, Nadia? Next up, we have Sexual Assault Awareness Month, and I'll invite Michael Amo up. He's our point person on this. He was involved with the formation of this committee, I believe. I'll let him speak first on the county exec, and then Nadia. That's okay. You want to invite the team up?
May I?
Sure.
Good morning, Mr. Michael Lamo, who, by the way, is a past president of our Mental Health Association, Orange County. So it's always a pleasure to see you. If I may, please ask the Rape Crisis Services team to come forward. That's Kathy Somerville, our crisis service manager. And then we have our community educators and advocates, Ashley Condit, Jennifer Velastro, and Asia Moore. And I don't think Tina could be with us today. Tina Keneally is our sexual assault examiner coordinator. So this is the team, ladies and gentlemen. This is the team that every day, 24/7, 365 days out of the year, support the needs of those individuals who are survivors of sexual assault. So ladies, you deserve a round of applause. Thank you.
Before I give it to Mike, I will mention a former commissioner, retired Chris Ashman, from Commissioner of Mental Health for the county for many years, is here as well. A Tennessee graduate too, by the way.
Thanks, Steve, appreciated it. This is special every year. We talk about this, and
Nadja remembers when we were involved in this and we started this whole program, and it was so important as a grassroots program. And I think one word about the Mental Health Association then and more now is it's so wonderful how they're able to identify a need and then go after it, unlike those of us in government who have to fight about a position or how we think about things. They just decide what we need and we go do it. And we know what we need, and we thank all of you for doing that. And so I just want to compliment Nadja and the crew at Mental Health Association for a job well done.
Thank you, Legislator Emo. One of the proudest things I can say that we've done in county government in the last 4 years is Nadja brought to my attention one day that the state of New York cut funding to the Rape Crisis Center, which is unconscionable to me. So our legislators up in Albany, for some reason or another, it snuck through the cracks in the funding for Rape Crisis, which handles almost one person a day if you average it out, would have shut down on, I think we were talking about Friday, Saturday. So the county government, they met with us. We all backed up together, the legislature, myself, locally, to make that happen. And, we see the district attorney and the sheriff and I go to a lot of things. We like to see you. We see you guys at a couple things out in Newburgh and also around the county at the National Night Out. And I'm so proud of the work that you do. And it's not an easy job by any means. You're not dealing with good news on a regular basis. You're helping people at probably one of the worst times of their lives. So I'm proud of all the work you do. You guys are friends, and thank you for being here today, and we definitely honor you.
Thank you, County Exec. We have a proclamation, and I'm not reading the whole proclamation because they are quite lengthy, but I'll read the first whereas again and the final now therefore. Sexual Assault Awareness Month, whereas sexual assault and rape occurs in 1 in 4 girls and 1 in 6 boys before the 18th birthday. And sexual assault and rape are the most unreported crimes. And now therefore be resolved that I, Stephen M. Newhouse, Orange County Executive, and L. Stephen Brescia, Chairman, do hereby proclaim the month of April 2017 Sexual Assault Awareness Month. Thank you for coming.
Thank you again. And I just want to bring to your attention the fact that what County Executive Newhouse says, and it was the reality, folks. At one point, we were poised with a difficult task that maybe we'd have to shut down the evenings and the weekend work because of lack of funding, which I think when we discussed, it struck a real chord with you and our chair and all of legislators, because somebody would have to decide, when is it that I'm going to be sexually assaulted? Just between 9 and 5, because even as the weekends, I'm not going to have the services. That's unconscionable. That's unconscionable. And our county heard us. And it doesn't happen like that in many counties. I work in another county for 15 years. It doesn't happen this way. So from the bottom of our hearts and from the voices of those individuals that we have the privilege to serve, we cannot thank the community that elected all of you. We cannot thank you enough to you and to our elected officials for your unwavering support. And our district attorney has been phenomenal with its On Us initiatives and different ways that we can educate our community. We saturate the community, we educate thousands and thousands of people. Sometimes a month, we can go hundreds and hundreds. So we're really excited about the prevention, the education, and the direct services that we provide. And I'm also very excited not only to have here with us our past commissioner, Mr. Ashman, but also our vice president of our board and the past president, Mr. Dave Goggins in the back, wonderful supporter of everything that we do, but also our newly appointed Orange County Human Rights Director, Inaudi Esposito, waved to us. Inaudi, so happy to have her. And Inaudi, for those of you that may not know, worked at the Mental Health Association, and she was our past sexual assault examiner coordinator. So I could not be happy to have amongst us here this morning people that have been with us through this journey for so many years and continue to support us. So Mr. Amo, Mr. Newhouse, Mr. Brescia, and all of you in the community and the Rape Crisis Services staff, thank you so much. We humbly accept this proclamation. We're thrilled, and we hope to be back here next year.
So just for the record, the county is known, we're not in trouble with Safe Homes or with you for having an Audi on here?
No.
Okay. A little bit, oh, there's still a little sore, but like you're doing better things, so we're happy to have you. The county legislature is happy to have you, I am, and obviously the commission.
We're just excited that now she can apply her expertise to a larger state. That's all we're looking for.
Great, thank you.
Thank you so much, and thanks again. Sorry, hope you didn't take too much of your time. Thank you so much.
Thank you again, Nadia. Thanks again, Nadia. And finally, we have one more. We have another proclamation, don't we? Oh, Nadia, you took the.
I want another one.
You got 2 out of 3. You want 3 out of 3. Okay, I'm going to invite up the 3 legislators that represent Warwick for this next, Animal Cruelty Prevention Month. And I will mention Legislator Mike Anagnostakis, who was instrumental in, you want to come up to? Come on up. You were instrumental in Rocky's Law being adopted. So, and I'd like to invite up Susan Barron, Michelle Little. The other Susan Barron, this is with a Y, Michelle Little, Town of Warwick Councilman Floyd D'Angelo, who was here last year, and Assemblyman Brabinick, if he's here. Floyd, thank you for coming. It's, year went by quick, so thank you for all you do, and County Exec, you want to present this proclamation?
Well, one of the first phone calls we got this morning, you guys are getting too close lately to legislature. One of the first phone calls we got at the office today was, can they bring a dog to the meeting today? And we obviously have no problem with it, and we are proud. When I was Chester supervisor, we had a contract with Warwick Valley Animal Hospital and Shelter, and they did all our calls for the police or everything. And I remember one call, which is like infamous over there. I came home from work one day, I was wearing a suit and tie, and a wild turkey was in my front lawn with an arrow through it. And one end was one, the back end of the arrow, and the other one was, and I called. I said, do you guys handle turkeys? And they said, yeah, bring it over. So one of the town cops comes to my house. I was supervisor at the time. I'm holding it with a suit and tie. I show up at their place. They did surgery on this turkey, and then they let it go, I think like a month or two later. So they are really a full-service shelter over there. I know you handle Warwick, Chester, and a lot of other places in between. And we're proud of the stuff you do. Obviously, animal cruelty is something in our society that we're all trying to fight. It's been highlighted recently with one of the football players recently, and also with Rocky's Law, which Mike and Anagnostakis inspired legislation on. But we still see this. We read this from time to time in the paper. And it's also behavior of cruelty towards animals is also very indicative of how people are going to treat other people as they get older. And we see a very distinct tie-in with people that abuse other people, and they've had a past of starting with animal cruelty. So that's why we're all on board to obviously celebrate Animal Cruelty Prevention Month. And Steve, you bet who wants to go next, because I know you got a lot of guys out here.
Slater, next time, you want to see.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you for signing that bill. And listen, it's Animal Cruelty Prevention Month. I think the key that we have to take away, not only the great job that you guys do in all the shelters across Orange County, but if you see something out there, say something. Don't keep quiet. Make a phone call. We set up a registry here. We set up a registry that's the toughest in the nation. And although I don't like to say it, it works. And there are 3 people on that registry right now. If you go to the website, you'll see them and you'll see all their information. That means those people can't commit another crime to an animal. And if some people say government really doesn't work, doesn't do anything, if you really believe that, just look at Rocky's Law. I think government does function right. Not only did we do it here, after we did it here in Orange County, we had another 3 or 4 counties come aboard in New York State with a registry. And believe it or not, I've had phone calls from people, elected officials, in California, in Florida, in Connecticut, in Idaho, and even from Ottawa, Canada. And they've started to move on a similar type of bill in their municipalities and states. So it's going to help animals in those places, and maybe one day we'll have such a thing across the United States of America. So God bless you for everything you do, and God bless all the end.
Thank you, Mike. Susan, are you going to speak? Okay. I just want to say that thank you to Warwick Humane Society. You are the preeminent Humane Society in Orange County. Don't tell Walden Humane Society I said that because they're in my district. But even though Mike represents Walden, they're in Walden Humane Society. But they do a fantastic job, too. Let them know I said that. So, but thank you, Susan. Say a few words, please.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Good morning to you all. Thank you so much for allowing us to come here today. And I thought a little twist would be actually for you to see a victim of animal abuse. This is Muffin. He is a 5-year-old Shih Tzu. His first owner attempted to do self-grooming without having skilled hands and nicked his eye, so he is now a one-eyed Shih Tzu. Then his second owner, due to intentional neglect, chose to ignore the fact that he has dry eye condition, which requires medication like four times a day. She did not bring him to a veterinarian. She allowed his coat to overgrow so badly, he was so matted he had to be sheared like a lamb. And he was infested with fleas that were pretty much killing him. Muffin survived. We intervened. Muffin survived. His owner has actually pled guilty to a misdemeanor charge. She can no longer own animals. And Muffin has been released for adoption. It was 1 year, so he is now available for adoption. He's a survivor. Thank you very much. I just want to say really quickly that Orange County and the town of Warwick has supported our organization throughout the years. And we are so, so fortunate to not only, it starts at the top, as we know, and it has filtered down. We have a district attorney who is well-versed in animal cruelty and has a team behind him who prosecutes these cases to the fullest. We have an Orange County Sheriff's Department that created the Animal Abuse Investigative team, and we now have 2 deputies and an investigator that goes out throughout the county to check on these cases. And just as you heard, if you see something, say something, you know, be their eyes, be their voice. If you want to remain anonymous, you can. We have a cruelty line you can call. It's 987-SCENE-7336, and you can remain anonymous and call from anywhere in the county. We will direct that call to who it belongs to. So I thank you again for recognizing April is Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month. It's Go Orange for Animals, as you see. So wear some orange this month. We'd appreciate your support. Thank you.
Okay. Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month, whereas Orange County, the citizens of Orange County and the Warwick Humane Society are concerned with humane treatment of animals. And now, therefore, it be resolved that Stephen M. Newhouse, an Orange County Executive, and L. Stephen Brescia, Chairman of the Legislature, hereby proclaim April 17th as Prevention of Animal Cruelty Month. Thank you again for everything. We thank Muffin. And she's got a Tennessee bandana on, too, so that's good, like Smokey. I neglected to mention Legislator Paul Ruskevich, Barry Cheney, and John Vero represent parts of Warwick.
Can I get pictures? You get it, that's a sign. See how much you are nice and in.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks again, you guys. 2 more orders of business. We have 2 25-year pins to present. Anne-Marie Maglione, are you still here? Is Anne-Marie here? Oh, here she comes. Okay, I'll invite up Tom Fagione, who's going to represent Stephanie Labuda because she lives in Sullivan County, but he's the closest legislator. And Gene Hansen, Majority Leader Melissa Bonasek, will come up for that one. Okay. Want to speak, Anne-Marie, first?
It's really my honor to be here and recognizing these 2 individuals that work for us. You know, I always say that we have a really great family at OFA, and we really do. It's dysfunctional, but it's a great family. And, you know, these Stephanie and Jean are a big part of it. They've been there for 25 years, and they're not just employees. They really care. These are the people that at 5 o'clock on a Friday, on a 3-day weekend, and we get a problem call, they don't leave. They stay and they make sure that the senior is taken care of and safe, and just all the situations are taken care of. So I am so proud to be part of this team, and I really appreciate you guys, and I want you to stay for a lot longer.
Yeah, the 25 years in the retirement pin, it's a thank you and keep charging forward. But we appreciate everything you do. My memory's a little foggy from the the state of the county last night, but I think we do 178,000 meals. Am I right, guys? Mike, am I right? Yeah, 178,000 meals a year. This team helps deliver to our senior citizens in our county, as well as all the other litany of things that you do to help them. I mentioned last night they're the most vulnerable population in Orange County. We see time after time where they're taken advantage of for scams. The district attorney, the New York State Attorney General, the sheriff, myself, and obviously the Office of the Aging are at the front of the line, are constantly giving speeches and lectures on how to avoid these scams. So we really appreciate you staying and being part of the team, and we want to thank you for your service.
I was going to take a little spin on this today, probably because my other hat is a school teacher. So I think 25 years is a long time. 25 years ago was 1992. And I know that probably a lot of our audience today sounds like a really long time ago. But I do want to share some facts of what was going on in 1992 when these two ladies started with Orange County. Americans with Disabilities Act went into effect. AT&T released their video telephone. That one I left. For you Ranger fans out there, New York Rangers clinched their first NHL regular season championship in 50 years. New York Lotto pays $30 million to one winner. And if anybody wants to write down the numbers, they were 12, 15, 30, 33, 40, and 48. Gilligan's Island, TV pilot filmed in 1964, first aired in 1992 on TBS television. U.S. Department of Transportation released their phrase, "Friends don't let friends drink and drive." I thought with our debate that our students had with our smoking, the selling of cigarettes and raising the age, the first nicotine patch is introduced to help stop smoking, and the cost of gasoline on average was $1.05. Those days I'm sure a lot of us miss. DNA fingerprinting is introduced, and the largest mall in America, Katie, I figured we would like this, Minnesota's Mall of America is constructed spanning 78 acres. So those are very important facts, but the most important fact is why we're here today. And that's these two ladies started with Orange County 25 years ago. And we're here today, we pause in our business to say thank you very much for the service and to all our county employees. But what an honor for us to have two people dedicate their time and hard work to our residents, especially our senior citizens. So congratulations, and sincerely hope you give us another 25 more years. Thank you.
I guess we'll just take a picture. We don't have a certificate for this. It's just the pins. Yeah. But thank you again. And 25 years is a long time, and we recognize that. A lot of people don't make it that long in county employee, you know. But we recognize the work you're doing, and thanks for coming in. signed up for the public portion. We will go right into the agenda. I just want to say two quick things about the mock session. One thing you could have done, you could have sent the local law, if you did not like it, back to committee, the two committees, to rehash it further before it came back. It has to sit on the desk for 10 days before it can come to the full legislature, and we can't amend it on the floor. If we pass it on the floor, it goes up to the Department of State, and then it's certified and becomes an official law. So just to let you know that, because it sounded like you might want to do that. You did have the luxury of amending it on the floor, which our attorney doesn't give us that latitude. Majority Leader Bonasson.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to approve the minutes of February 2nd, 2017.
Second. Objection, that'll be done. Okay, are there any referrals, consents, or withdrawals? None? Okay, I guess on to legislative item number one.
Legislators Benton and Benelli, resolution reviewing and affirming the Orange County Debt Management Policy.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Salvo, absent, Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
And number two.
Legislators Benton and Anagnostakis, resolution amending and reaffirming the Orange County investment policy pursuant to Article 3, Section 3.02D of the Orange County Charter and Section 39 of the New York State General Municipal Law.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number three.
Legislators Benton and Kulisek, resolution approving the release of the county's interest in and to a certain deed sale parcel to the previous owner of record pursuant to Section 5, Paragraph B1 of Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number four.
Legislators Benton and Riskevich, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQRA, with respect to the replacement of Logtown Road Bridge in the town of Greenville, making a preliminary determination that this project be listed as an unlisted action.
Second.
Okay, add Bonasek. Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number five is a bond resolution requiring a two-thirds vote. Number five.
Legislators Riskevich, Turnbull, Benton, O'Donnell. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the preparation of surveys, preliminary and detailed plans, specifications, and estimates necessary for the Logtown Road Bridge replacement in the town of Greenville, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $50,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 50,000 bonds of the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Okay. Discussion? Yes, Legislator Angus Knox.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'll be in support of this, but I figured, let me just say a few words because we have all the students out here and they're probably wondering. We're going to run through all these legislative requests that are going to be approved today, or laws or resolutions, and you might not hear anyone say anything. And the reason is, unfortunately, they haven't come on a hot topic day. They haven't come on a day when an issue would be up that would merit big debate and maybe even split vote on the legislature. So you just might hear nothing throughout the whole session. And when you hear legislators not say anything after the first few say yes, nothing said is an implied yes. So that's what you're seeing. You're seeing government in action to move through 30 resolutions or laws that we think are necessary for the county without any debate and without any talk. So, sorry.
That's very true. If you want to come back on a hot topic day, you're more than welcome. We'll notify your schools.
We're not done yet.
Well, at the end, maybe we're, yeah. That's right, we have open discussion at the end sometimes, right, Matt? Okay, where are we? We get a second, and we're ready for roll call. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduch? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number six.
Legislators Turnbull and Benelli, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Public Works to approve the replacement, maintenance, and support of the existing sewer mains by the New York State Department of Transportation for the proposed project to replace the Route 208 bridge over Heritage Trail in the village of Monroe.
Second.
Discussion. Yes. Myrna wants to be added. Yes. And Jim Kulisek?
Yes.
Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduch? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Number seven.
Legislators Benelli and Vero, resolution confirming the reappointments and appointment by the county executive to the board of directors of the Orange County Soil and Water Conservation District.
Second.
Discussion?
Yes.
Legislator Turnbull.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman. I hesitate to comment on this resolution because I know that how at times the chairman can be a little bit sensitive to criticism, but I'd be lax in my duty if I didn't say something. This appointment, I'm going to be supporting it today, but I just want to make it clear that I feel like the protocol has been disregarded. Over a year ago, the chairman came to me and asked me to submit a name for this committee, and we kind of disagreed on the name that I wanted to submit. Subsequently, he went and submitted a Republican rather than a Democrat to the committee, and when I challenged the chairman, asked him why he did that, he said, well, you didn't give me a name, which really wasn't accurate. Subsequently, I see now that he's appointed Myrna Chemnitz to this committee. Myrna is, you know, just a very skilled legislator. She probably works as hard as any legislator that I know and is a very suitable appointment to this committee, but it did not go through me. You know, she was appointed to this committee without any discussion or give me the opportunity to make the appointment. And the reason I think this is important is that legislators get elected to districts by the people in that district. And when they're denied the opportunity to represent the people in their district, this is a violation, a serious violation of the very principle that our government is based on.
Legislator Riskevich.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to clarify for the record that these appointments are made by the county executive and confirmed by the legislature. So it wasn't the chairman's appointment. Thank you.
Why did he ask
you? No, it's not wrong. It's fairly well spelled out. It's the appointments are made by the county executive. Thank you.
Okay, Legislator Fagione wants to be added as sponsor. Roll call.
Steve, yes, so please.
Barry wants to be added as well. And John Bureau. And Majority Leader Bonasek. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis?
Abstain.
Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduch, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham. 17 ayes, 2 abstentions.
Okay, number 8.
Legislators Kulisek and Turnbull, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQRA, with respect to the replacement of Orange Spring Bridge in the town of Mount Hope, making us up a preliminary determination that this project be classified as an unlisted action.
Second.
Discussion? Yes. Bonasek and Fagione added. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek? Turnbull? Amo, Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 9 is a bond resolution requiring 2/3 votes.
Legislators Turnbull, Kulisek, Benton, DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the preparation of surveys, preliminary and detailed plans, specifications and estimates necessary for the Orange Spring Bridge replacement in the town of Mount Hope, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $50,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of 50,000 bonds of the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. Agion added. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo,
yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 10.
Legislators Turnbull, Benton, and Anagnostakis. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the acquisition of fleet and equipment for solid waste operations at Orange County Transfer Stations number 1, number 2, and number 3, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $123,500, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $123,500 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Okay, 14 votes needed as well. Fagione added. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? And Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 11, another bond resolution.
Legislators Bonasek, DeSalvo, Benton, and O'Donnell. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the construction of capital improvements at the Orange County Jail, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of 100,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Fagione added. And Benelli added. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 12, another bond.
Legislators Fagione, Bonasek, Benton, and Hines. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing a replacement of building equipment at the Orange County Jail, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of 100,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia, 19 ayes.
Bond resolutions require 2/3 vote because that's we're going to borrow money to pay it back over 10 years, 20 years, or 30 years, just so you know that. Okay, number 13.
Legislators Ekus and Bonasek, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept grant funds from the New York State Department of Homeland Security and Emergency Services pursuant to Section 99-H of General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Okay, Party Leader Amo and then Majority Leader Bonasek.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Sort of serendipitous yesterday while out for a morning walk in Woodbury, I met a local police officer who was on his way to training and met our newest in-training officer, Zeke Shepherd, who was very, very young on his way for training to be one of these explosive detection canine animals. And really a great opportunity to meet both the officer and to see this soon to be a police officer for us. And that was really great. The heartening thing was that I learned that we needed an explosive dog in Orange County. That seemed to scare me a little bit, especially in Woodbury. I didn't think that was necessary, but I guess times are changing.
Majority Leader Coniston.
Yeah, my name too.
All sponsors, Republican and Independents.
Yes.
Legislator Ricas.
I just wanted to mention that a number of our canine police officers just returned Wednesday from Carolina, having competed in a national competition, and they did very well. So congratulations to all of them.
Thank you. Roll call.
Oh, please.
Kulisek added. Okay, roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Emo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 14.
Legislators DeSalvo and Ekis. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept funds from the New York State Department of Homeland Security and Emergency Services pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Okay, all Republicans want to be added? Yes. Jim Kulisek added?
Yes.
Matt? M's and Independents. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo,
yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 15.
Legislators Paduk and DeSalvo, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept and appropriate funds from the New York State Division of Criminal Justice Services pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. All Republicans?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Matt? All Dems?
Okay.
Okay. Amo as well. Okay, roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 19 ayes.
Okay, number 16.
Legislators Hines and Bonasek, resolution confirming the appointment and reappointment by the county executive to the Orange County Police Advisory Board pursuant to Section 18.07A of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Legislator Ekis added. Yep. Okay. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 19 ayes.
Okay, 17 through 20 are all bond resolutions requiring a two-thirds vote. Number 17.
Legislators Sullivan, Berkman, Benton, bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing replacement of automatic sliding doors at the Valley View Center, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $30,600. Appropriating said amount, therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 30,600 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Okay, yes, discussion. Myrna wants to be added. Legislator Anagnostakis.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. 17 through 20, the next four are going to be bonding resolutions for our nursing home, Valley View. And people that are on my committee and the Ways and Means Committee already know the answer, but just in case you don't, the reason. Someone asked me, why are we bonding one of these particular ones? And the reason is, when you do a capital improvement project at the nursing facility, they actually will get reimbursed through Medicaid over the next few years when it kicks in 75% of the cost. So when you see a bonding resolution at Bellevue, eventually you're only paying 25% of that cost. And I think we have Mr. Ledoux in the audience, and I want to take this moment to personally thank him for the tremendous turnaround at the Valley View, the way he's run that operation. One of our accountants last year said they had never ever seen such a turnaround in New York State, and they handle most of the nursing homes in New York State. So I want to thank you for doing what some of us up here as legislators knew was possible with that facility. Thank you, Mr. Ledoux.
Yes, Matt.
The answer.
Okay, any other? Yes, Legislator Vannelli.
Okay. Jim O'Donnell as well. And I will reiterate what Legislator Anagnostakis, if most of you have not read the article in the Times Herald Record, it was a very good article. It makes us all very happy, I think, with the turnaround. And Lawrence Ledoux certainly deserves the most credit, but I would also thank the other personnel, the employees there, the CSEA employees. This legislature and the county executive for the early retirement systems and the separation agreements that helped us get here also. We tend to forget about that sometimes. And working as a team, a bipartisan team on this effort. I think we're all very happy with the direction that Valley View is going. Roll call. Oh, I'm sorry, Legislator Beck.
Thank you. Yes, I think we also should thank all the taxpayers in Orange County for all of the taxes that they actually sent to Washington that are sent back to us as reimbursements and IGT money, because it comes out of everybody's pocket one way or the other.
Okay, roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 18.
Legislators Chemnitz, Sullivan, Benton, and DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the upgrading of the nursing call bell system at the Valley View Center, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $200,000. Appropriating said amount, therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 200,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion.
Legislator Berkman.
Please add my name. And since we were talking about this bipartisan effort, that was after the Democrats and Mr. Anagnostakis saved Valley View.
Yes, Paduk added as well. Okay, O'Donnell added. Okay, roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 19.
Legislators Sullivan, Chemnitz, Benton, Benelli. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the refurbishment of residential units at the Valley View Center, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $40,000, appropriating said amount, therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 40,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Okay, discussion.
Yes.
Paduk added. Roll call. O'Donnell added. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Number 20.
Legislators Amo, Ekis, Benton, and Dillard. Bond resolution dated April 7, 2017. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the replacement of residential bathing tubs at the Valley View Center, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $84,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of 84,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Yes, Myrna added, O'Donnell added, Paduk added. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 21.
Legislators Sullivan and Chemnitz. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Valley View Center for Nursing Care and Rehabilitation to accept and appropriate funds from the New York State Occupational Safety and Health Hazard Abatement Board pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. You want to be added? O'Donnell added. Roll call.
Bodasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha. 19 ayes.
Okay, number 22.
Legislators Berkman and O'Donnell, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Valley View Center for Nursing Care and Rehabilitation to accept and appropriate funds from the New York State Department of Health pursuant to Section 99-H of a general municipal law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. O'Donnell's already on this one, so we're covered. Okay, roll call.
Roseanne wants to be out of it, right?
Duke, okay. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 23.
Legislators Chemnitz and Sullivan, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Health to accept and appropriate funds from the New York State Department of Health pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes.
Okay. 24.
Legislators O'Donnell and Ekis, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Health to appropriate fourth-year budget period funds from the New York State Department of Health Bureau of Tuberculosis Control pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Benelli and Sullivan added. Okay. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 25.
Legislators Hines, DeSalvo, and Bonasek, resolution of the Orange County Legislature requesting a traffic study and reduction of speed limit on New York State Route 9W between the town of Cornwall and the town of Highlands pursuant to New York State Vehicle and Traffic Law Section 1620.
Second.
Discussion. Legislator Hines, I knew you'd want to speak on this.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. This came about, it's really a home rule request. It came about as a result of a public safety meeting that I attended in the village of Cornwall on Hudson. It was hosted by the town of Cornwall emergency manager, Kurt Hahn. The meeting was attended by New York State DOT, state and local elected officials, fire departments, ambulance corps, police agencies. And this was our second meeting. 2 years ago, we had a meeting, and it was really to improve the safety on Storm King Mountain, both in inclement weather and heavy traffic situations. And what came out of this year's meeting was that we thought because of there's so many tourists that use Route 9W, especially when Route 218 is closed for inclement weather, when they're visiting West Point and things of that nature, that they're not really familiar with the mountain. And if you're not familiar with the mountain, it can be very dangerous. There's a lot of sharp curves. There's some poor drainage areas that the state cannot fix, and they admit that they cannot fix it because it would be tremendous money in blasting and things of that nature. So if you're familiar with the area, you know where certain areas freeze and where some of the sharp turns are. But if you're not from the area, that's when we see some of our worst accidents. I also serve as a fireman in Cornwall, and I've seen some horrendous accidents up there. And a lot of times it's motorcyclists on great, beautiful, sunny days, as well as tourists on bad weather days, because they just don't realize that sometimes when you come around one of those sharp turns, it can be an icy condition or already an accident ahead, and they don't have time to stop. Once that mountain is closed, West Point's our biggest employer, so if there's an accident up there, there's not a lot of room to get around it. So it's a huge issue. We thought that if we lower the speed limit from 55 to 45, people will still probably speed on the mountain, and the police admit they probably won't pull people over up there because there's no place to pull them over safely, so they'd have to get them at the end of the mountain. But we thought it would be something for a tourist if they're going. They see a 55 mile an hour sign, they're probably going 65 or 70, but if they see a 45 mile an hour sign, maybe they'll slow down to 55 or 60. So that's the premise behind this. The village of Cornwall and Hudson, the town of Cornwall, and the town of Highlands have all passed similar resolutions. Senator Larkin's office was represented there, and Assemblyman Skoufis was at the meeting. They said they were going to work on this as well, and DOT said that they would bring it to their bosses. So I hope everybody supports this. It's really a public safety issue for everybody, not only our residents, but the tourists as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Legislator Hines, for bringing this. And I will say that Legislator DeSalvo echoed your concerns at Rules and Public Safety, the statutory committees. And we have a few O'Neill students here today. Maggie, are you O'Neill? Or yeah, so you know where he's talking about with this stretch of, it's a little dangerous, but and it's very important. So any other discussion, Legislator Benoit?
Mr. Chairman, thank you very much. And I want to thank Legislator Hines for bringing this attention to the Rules Enactments and Intergovernmental Relations Committee. We had a very good discussion on this, and quite frankly, this is something that is well overdue, so I'm more than happy to support this, and I'd like my name to be added. Thank you.
Certainly. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulwasek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 26.
Legislators Bonasek and Chemnitz. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature requesting a traffic study and reduction of speed limit on Forest Road, Orange County Highway 23 in the town of Newburgh between the town-county boundary with town of Plattekill, Ulster County, and New York State Route 300 pursuant to New York State Vehicle and Traffic Law Section 1622.
Second.
Discussion, Legislator Benton.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I'd like to ask that my name be added as well. And I'd like to thank everyone in advance for their support of this. Right now, with our passage, we would be the second, as far as I know, the second level of government to approve this. This is a coming and piggybacking with a resolution from the town of Newburgh Town Board requesting this study. We're going to have a situation this summer where the DOT, the state DOT, is replacing the bridge in Plattekill that goes over the thruway. So this route, which is already a dangerous route, it has a lot of straightaways, which obviously encourages speeding, with, at the end of those, some sharp turns, which are dangerous. So it definitely is a dangerous road. And it's also unique in that it has two different speed limits when it crosses the county border. So I understand that my counterpart in the Ulster County Legislature, Kevin Roberts, is also working to get the local town of Plattekill and the Ulster County Legislature to support a study. So hopefully the state takes the, you know, the DOT gets the point and is putting a little pressure, well, by us putting a little pressure on them, maybe they will actually lower the speed limit and lower than 45 and at least be consistent too, because I know when people see a detour construction zone and a route, they're already behind schedule or late, and they would have a tendency to even speed up even faster. So hopefully we can really alleviate any unnecessary accidents and make the road safer during this time.
Okay. Yes, Benton added. Kulwasek wants to be added. Okay.
Mr. Chairman, I'd just like to make an alteration in the second whereas, last sentence, to go from seed limit to speed limit. Good catch. Okay, the teacher in you.
Okay. All right, roll call. Yes, Legislator Benoit.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would just like to point out the distinction between the previous resolution and this resolution. This resolution has to do during a construction period of time. The other resolution is a permanent resolution that hopefully will pass in the state legislature, and they do the study and we move forward. This is for the construction period that we that is upcoming. So I just wanted to state that distinction, and I'd be happy to add my name as well. Thanks.
Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulwasek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 27.
Legislators Bonasek and Chemnitz. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature in support of an application to the New York State Department of State for a countywide resiliency planning grant.
Second.
Discussion? Yes. Berkman added, Paduk added. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Bid number 28.
Legislators Benelli, Amo, Bonasek, DeSalvo, Fagione, Hines, Kulisek, and Chemnitz. Resolution recognizing April 24th, 2017 as Holocaust Memorial Day, Yom HaShoah.
Second.
Okay, all Republicans, Melissa?
Yes.
All Democrats, and Michael Amo? Yes. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 29.
Legislators Ekis and Dillard, resolution confirming the reappointments by the county executive to the Orange County Foreign Trade Zone Management Board.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Yes, Amos, yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cheney, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, O'Donnell, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha. 18 ayes, one abstention.
Okay, number 30.
Legislators Ekis and Dillard, resolution designating Orange County Tourism as a tourism promotion agency of Orange County pursuant to section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Legislator Berkman. Berkman is added, and Turnbull wants to.
Now, first of all, I'd like to thank the county executive for his state of the county last night, sharing credit. I think Valley View's the defining issue for this county for the last several years, and boy, oh boy, you can't really give Mr. Ledoux enough credit.
We need to vote on this, right? We're on 30, aren't we? Is this, okay, I'm sorry, are you talking to 30?
Yeah,
or
I am. I am. I just wanted to say that first.
Oh, okay.
I knew I wasn't. You know, in a discussion last night with some of the other legislators, we were talking about tourism in Orange County, and of course thinking about that because it was featured in the State of the County address. And we're really looking forward to some of the things the county executive talked about. A couple of things we really missed the boat on is, and the other legislators laugh whenever I bring this up because I've been fanatical about it, is Orange County has some of the best golf anywhere in New York State. I mean, it's just unbelievable. If you like golf like I do, this is a great place to live. Not only are there wonderful golf courses to play, but the price is right. And the county has two of the best golf courses in New York State. We need to feature those golf courses. So we talked about a program that is going to be Golf Orange, and we think it's going to really have a great impact on tourism in Orange County. Anthony and I was talking to Wayne Booth last night. Both of us are avid fishermen. We were saying, well, why not fish Orange County? You know, clean up our streams and put some trout in there. And boy, you're going to see a lot of people come up from the city. Instead of making the trek all the way to Sullivan County, they could stop here at Orange County, spend their money here in Orange County, and it'd really be a good thing. We need to think outside the box sometimes.
Okay, thank you. Yes, Legislator Benton.
I think the state does deserve thanks for the thousands and thousands of fish, the trout that they already do stock in our local streams.
Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Yes. Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cheney? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? O'Donnell? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresha? 19 ayes, Mr. Chairman, and the desk is clear.
Your vote counts. I'd like to wish everyone a happy Easter and a Passover as well. And we have one speaker signed up. Bennett Weiss from Newburg, decorum at meetings is the subject.
Thank you. As I'm sure most of you remember, last month there was a pretty inflamed incident here when I was called out for not standing up for the Pledge of Allegiance. I was quite upset and may have not been clear in my response to that day, so I want to be very clear right now about how I feel about what happened and the aftermath of it. After that happened, the rules of decorum were read here, and it was implied, I believe, that there was a violation of decorum by yours truly, me. I want to say that I find that quite insulting. The violation of decorum was by the county executive, who chose to make a statement about my perfectly legal action and condemn it. Afterwards, I didn't say a word to him. I didn't even look at him for about maybe 10 minutes. And I thank Mr. Turnbull for defending me. When Mr. Turnbull gave me a defense, I glanced over to see what the county executive's reaction was, and he gave me this little nasty little salute, which is essentially the equivalent of flipping the bird. I reflexively responded in kind, and then I shut up. So I don't think I violated decorum in any way other than reflexively and spontaneously, and I believe quite understandably. But I want to talk about what the very terrifyingly precocious young man quoted his father as saying about autistic kids, how some of us think inside the box, some of us think outside the box, but autistic kids think about the box. So in the minute or so I have left, I'd just like to talk about the box. What is the box? The box creates a gravitational force on any issue. In this particular place, it's the Pledge of Allegiance. And what it does is when people huddle in the box, everyone tends to huddle into that box. It's human nature, okay? You have to realize that this Pledge of Allegiance that we have and that we take as if it were written by the Founding Fathers, it has no legal or national institutional history beyond custom. Custom. And what is the function of this box? The function of this box is indoctrination. The function of this box is to create a sense of having met your patriotic obligation simply by saying some words. And I think that the audience would know that this might not be true, because these young people, if they, by the time they graduate school, will have said the pledge, if my arithmetic is right, about 2,200 times. 2,200 times in 12 of the 17 years of their lives, okay? And yet, that demographic is the least likely to vote. The least likely to vote. So what is its, does it work? Does it instill patriotism? Of course not. Its sole function is to create this groupthink. Groupthink is dangerous to democracy, not promotive of it. The first word of the Pledge of Allegiance is I, right? I pledge, not we, it's not a collective thing. It's an individual choice. Keep it that way.
Thank you. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. We're adjourned. We'll see the legislators that are going to the lunch at the Holiday Inn, I believe. At Crystal Run. Thank you.